Hello everyone, my name is Sumit and once again I welcome all of you to BISP self-running video broadcast solution. Today I am going to discuss a new topic in ClickView, that how to analyze the offline data which we have extracted from the Google Analytics about the website visit or the unique visitor of a website in an Excel file, and I'm going to create a chart. I'm going to analyze that data by using a click view in the form of various charts, in the form of a line chart. So let's suppose we have a website www.xyz.com and it's a commercial website, and that commercial website has got number of visitors or unique page views. So I would like to know that how many users they have visited the website or they have liked the link, and one, so I'll extracted the data from that website and stored in an Excel sheet. I'm going to analyze it using ClickView. So let's move on to ClickView and do the analysis. So first of all, let me show you my data. So that's the data which I have extracted from the website. So I have got two sections over there, page view and unique visitors, and I'm going to analyze the data between this date and this date. For January, 3rd January till 2nd February. So that's the number of pages views by the users, and these are the records, unique visitor records. So I would like to analyze both in the form of a line chart by using ClickView. So let's do the analysis. Let's start the analysis. So for that, first of all, I'm going to create a new ClickView document. So I'll save it, and I give a name Google Analysis. Okay. Now I'm going to load the data into ClickView. So click on Edit Script, Table Files. Look for your file, the data analysis, Google Analytics data. That's the file, the Excel sheet. I open it. But if you see, the data is not in a proper format, because first of all, the heading is not appropriate. Second thing, there are few unwanted lines. These are blank lines. So we are not going to include these lines into our script. So I want to eliminate them. So how to eliminate them? You can see we have a section. We have an option header size. So I set the header size by line till line number 6. So header size will become line number 6. And the label, I change them to embedded labels. So now the data is in a proper format as required. I click on finish, save and reload it. So data will be loaded and it will be added into this ClickView. So now first of all, let's add a table box, and in this table box, I want to show all. So I click on apply and all. So that's the, we have records. Now I'm going to create a line chart to analyze it further. So right click on the blank area and new sheet object, chart, give a title, Google Analysis. Chart type will be line chart. Chart type is line chart. Next, first step is we have to look for the dimension. So I'm going to select the day dimension. So add day dimension as here, and I check this as well, suppress when value is null. So if there is any null value in days, it will be removed, that suppress it. Next, expression. So first expression, I add page views, and one more expression I want to add, that is unique visitor. So you can see here, it has been added, but at present, both of them, the unique visitor and the page view, they are on the same axis. I want to change their axis. I want to display the page views on another axis. So again, I right click on the properties on the chart, and I'll move to axis, and I change the page view axis. By default, if you see here, the page views and unique visitor, their position are both on the left side. So I select the page views and change its position to right top. So you can see here, one more dimension has been added. Okay. Next step, if I expand it, the date field is too big, so I would like to, in a proper format, again I right click on the properties, move to axis, and I set there, it will be in horizontal. in this format, horizontal, for both unique visitor and for page views, and apply. See, we have got this in vertical position. And the date field, if you see the date is too long, I would like to show only the, in the, I would like to change the format for this date. So how to change the format? Go to dimension. The dimension which we have added, we have to edit this. So I click on edit, and instead of this, I write equal to, I specify a format, date, days, comma, format, dd/mm. And comma, so is equal to date, so date, then the column name, expression, the it's the dimension is day, and the format is dd/. I want in this format. So we can check the expression is okay. It says that it's okay. I click on okay, and when I click on apply and okay, you will see the format has been changed, and now we can easily do the comparison between them. We can easily do the comparison. We can easily analyze them, that the date field, the unique visitor, and the page views, we can easily compare them. And if you want to compare only a specific section, we can compare that as well, where they are meeting, or which one is going up or which one is going high. So we can do the comparison, or we can select from here as well and we can compare them. So this is how we can do the analysis on Google Analytics data. This is offline data. In my next consecutive video, I will be going to do the same analysis, but that will be in real-time data. And in that real-time data, as soon as the data change in the data sheet or in Google Analytics, it will affect our click view as well. It will affect the chart as well. So that's all in this video. I hope this video helped you to understand how to do the analysis on Google Analytics offline data. I'll be coming up with some new videos. If you have any questions, you can visit our website www.bisptrainings.com, or you can subscribe our YouTube channel for more videos on. See you again. Bye.